Guys, I'm going to go ahead and do this live, but I'm going to have a recorded and rendered and edited version of this with some samples, if you will, what I mean here. But I'm going to try to give you some more practical approaches to doing the splits here. Kind of, I want to try to say it, give you examples how it resembles maybe doing some kind of work, like how you can be standing maybe like this, maybe there's a hole in the ground and you dug all around some kind of tree that you cut down or bush, and then you're digging it out, and you never. I'm just gonna give a couple examples. The other example can be you're in something where there's water running here, and you're doing some kind of work looking for rocks, or you drop something in the water. I seen YouTube videos that people were doing this and standing on a thing. There's water down here, whether it's concrete over here, whether it's like a creek or a brook, but. And we'll use, and this doesn't have to, not necessarily have to be a weapon or a sword like in any anime or anything. This can be a tool, any tool. You're stabbing, chipping it away at something or jabbing at something. It doesn't have to be a weapon. It's held like this or this. But yet, it's the same thing as small club bells or batons that people are using in yoga. It matches that. And I'm trying not to make this the same thing here. I'm giving, put forth the proposition, like say you stand here, what your legs not too far apart, not too close together, what you're comfortable with, right? And a surface that you don't slip, but you can allow yourself to slip a little bit and have control over it. Stand like this while watching something on your iPhone on a stand. Like instead of just talking to you in this video, maybe I'm watching something on there or listening to music. Or maybe watching TV. Maybe just do a whole sessions of just standing like this. Then what you do is actually like you're going to grab something, any object, or just put your hand somewhere. Come back up, then back down, then back up. And then you're almost mimicking other kind of poses people are doing in yoga or ballet. But I also say no disrespect to any ballet or particular yoga or martial art. I'm trying to say don't you imitate it, but don't imitate it too much. I was trying to put forth, without disrespect, a proposition that all those things I'm talking about, there's disciplines involved. And at the same time, you can say it can also be a box. And I'll say something reality-based. For example, unlike anybody that's just a dancer or a ballet person or a yoga person by trade, some of us are not that. I told you about myself already, stuff that I did, say, in workplaces, maybe during work or on break during work, because I did some of my videos with music reflected that. But that may be your reality, right? Whether you're doing it while taking a break at work or whether you're doing some work outside of a workplace and you're doing something in your yard, like I said, digging something. And then you're doing something like that anyway. Well, I also will tell you real quick while it's on my mind, the concept too, or I almost wanted to do a joke, like do a Jeff Foxworthy thing. Somebody should do that on YouTube. Redneck yoga, whether it's a dude or a chick. Because I had this thing where I was like, say I was helping my stepdad back in the years ago, or any for reason, say you ever had to look under a car. Different ways you can go and look underneath your car. You can get right down on the ground and be like, okay, what's going on with that muffler? Or almost like you're in this weird push-up position. I was there like this. You're looking, hair in my face. You're looking underneath like this. Your legs all kind of way. Well, guess what? You're almost doing some kind of yoga pose anyway, and there's all these different primal movement mixed with yoga, running back and forth side to side on the hands or on the fists. I mean, it's that. That's what I call reality based out there in your world. Where, yeah, no disrespect to any ballet, martial arts, or dancer, or yoga disciplines. I understand disciplines. Everything from army push-ups. You don't want to have no disrespect for those things you call disciplines, but sometimes it can be a box. You have to think outside of the box, maybe, when you're doing something to improve your actual life. But anyway, okay, on with that. I'll try to explain this to you anyway. Like this. Just stand like that for a bunch of time and go and grab this, put it down, grab it and put it down. Get back up, grab this, put it over here, back and recover. Or maybe just with or without, act like you're going to grab this, but don't. Or even without it, okay? Touch over here. And this is before you eventually try to venture into going a little further with the split. And I can do it, like slide into a split. Like, I admit, it's tricky. All right, I'll tell you one thing, too. It's kind of, not to be lewd, but it's kind of funny, but say as polite as possible. Any chick, a yoga chick or a cheerleader, sports cheerleader, or dancer, bam, go down in a side split just like that. But a lot of us, that we don't have perfect balance and have the tendency when we're doing a split, lean forward. We don't want to fall backward on our head, and then we don't, you're kind of into it. I did do a video where I did it almost. But to be polite, you want to bring up humorously without being lewd that you have risk of doing an unplanned ballet called the Nutcracker. Not being lewd, it was a fact, because what is sometimes, like, I always admit that my leg type too, that I showed you before, I can get into some of them splits as it is, and I did something where I was kind of like falling into it. There's that danger when you get all the way down, and like when you slide into it and you get this far, you're sliding into it gracefully, and then you got so much flexibility, you get down, right? And say you land, say you're just sliding into the split without touching the floor, and you go to stop yourself, but at the same time you stop yourself, ouch, Nutcracker. But anyway, but then people like me, though, too, I have to stretch every single day, I'll get all the way down here like this, and you can still feel it's like a bungee cord going. Then I have to warm up a couple times, and then I can go no hands and clap my hands, put them over my head. But then, yeah, once you got pretty warmed up, right, you go to slide into that split. And I'd have to show you my side profile to show you what I'm talking about. But you instinctively want to go forward. There's a spot where, depending on, what you're wearing, yeah, you kind of... Not quite. It's close to the equivalent of smacking your groin while you're riding a bike. You're bouncing around somewhere, like riding a bike, and like the position, bend on the position here, you just kind of bounce one to one side and boom, ah, not fun. But anyway, like, even though my splits, like, eventually, like, when I get down, it's like a bungee cord, and that almost at the same time, sometimes maybe you're more sooner, because like this will feel kind of like bungee cords, even though I got all the way down, right? I, in a sense, theoretically, have more risk of when I try to slide down into a split too hard. And theoretically, I have more risk of blowing a tendon or some kind of a thing, or ripping something, than actually. But yeah, you're actually. But some days where I actually do a whole bunch of times splits like this, some of us, we can go a couple days and we keep our flexibility, but me, I admit not. That's up to you guys, what if I asked the question, the answer would vary. Average person, it can vary from person to person, in my opinion, no matter what you're into. I would say ask a particular person, how long can you keep your splits without doing nothing? Can you go a day, 2 days, 3 days a week? I don't know, ask the amateur or dancer or yoga person. Or and ask somebody that's maybe fourth, fifth degree black belt, the answer might be different. I don't know, you know. It's, I think it all depends on you. Like I said, don't pretend to be something you're not and go lying to people. I mean, the key to learning a lot of stuff is being honest with yourself and not lying to other people. But there are some people that'll lie about something, make it a notch up a little bit, and then they're almost there anyway. You gotta be a little careful. There's the fake it till you make it thing, you know, somewhere along the line. Yeah. But my problem is, like I said too, by me personally, if I do something every single day, if I go maybe even 2 days without doing anything, I gotta start almost over. I get the whole flexibility back in, I don't know, about 10-15 minutes. Like, do it, take a break, and multiple times, you know what I mean? But anyway, what I was doing this video about, really, I forgot. But anyway, I wanted to make it in the explain sessions of standing just like this. How long can you stay like this without slipping? Do it for a particular length of time, with a song playing. And do a lot of, you know, grabbing of things, raising this over your head. We'll see. The way I got this right now is I could, this camera, I have to move backwards to show you a little bit because my head disappears. But in a more open area, raising this over your head. Take my word for it, I raise it over my head. And then like this, whether it's a weapon or not. Even if you're not intending to, even if you're not intentionally imitating or trying to be Van Damme and Cyborg over top, ready to chop the one guy's head off, you can imitate it to a point, get the basic idea of it. Even if it's not that, you're doing this. But you're not always hitting something. You could be. Well, you do a thing like a stabbing motion too. But I like to go all the way down here and then all the way back up. Raise this over my head. Like a stabbing type of motion. Can be a sword too. Then it also could be down and up, down and up. Anyway, if you stay in this position like that, do a little bit of this, down and up. Bend the legs. But even without this, you're kind of crawling thing. Well, there was a thing where I did to it with a Danzig song, the song from Danzig called Five Finger Crawl. I was doing, trying to prove a point, but anyway. People that do this, everything from dancers to ballet to yoga to everything, but same time you can find yourself in this position or this position, you know, doing some kind of work. But okay, so you venture into it eventually, right? Have your foot go a little bit here, a little bit this way, but stop. See how you hold it? Okay, my foot slide a little here now. Okay, hold it. Then a little more. Watch, then I can, whoops, see, I have to stop with my hands. See, that's why I can never do it perfect. I'm almost sliding into it. But there's a thing where, you know, I don't want to embarrassingly fall backwards or embarrassingly fall on my face, because my leg and hip type, if I would show you a side profile, it's not perfect. You know what I mean? But anyway, what I was trying to say before all that other stuff on my mind, a lot of the keys to it, actually, one of the keys I was trying to tell you is just standing like this for like a long period of time and then venture into going down and then up and then down and up and try to mimic maybe something that you're wearing shoes or in sprawled out some kind of way. Maybe you're digging something, you know what I'm saying? You're digging or doing some kind of work that you could be doing anyway. What I'm trying to say, you doing it according to not so much laughingly trying to convince anybody you're a karate man or saying that you're some kind of yoga expert. Admit that you're an amateur and you're just, admit to the way you're figuring it out. Maybe the best way, the best approach is to do it honestly. And You can mimic some other things to a point, but only if you kind of associate it with maybe stuff that you're doing in life anyway, whether some workplace or some work out in your yard. Like if you're standing in some kind of weird position and you're expand upon that, you know what I'm saying? But all right, that's enough for today.